Hi everyone, welcome back to our ongoing series on how to create a life operating system in Notion. Today's going to be a really cool one because today I'm unveiling and doing a walkthrough the new version 2 of the Command Center. The Command Center was really the first video I shared of the entire operating system back in the beginning. I showed how to make it and it's become a classic at this point in the series. So I'm now unveiling an enhancement, an improvement on many levels of the Command Center. It looks better and it functions way better. It's much more dynamic, it's more streamlined, it's actually simpler functionally in many ways, while looking better and just having a lot more connectivity and automation built into it. So excited to unveil this. In fact, there are two versions of it, so I'm going to show you two alternating options that you can choose from. This is building heavily on the previous video on pillars, an expansion of the pillars concept and a better explanation of the pillars concept. So you should definitely check that out with this video, the one before this on the pillars expansion. And finally, before we get started, wanted to mention that we have launched our online community, a membership community of really passionate, active people interested in all things Notion, pillars, pipelines, and vaults, mental clarity, mind expansion, knowledge management, productivity, systems for business ideas, systems thinking. These are all channels in the new community, and the community is taking off. It's an exciting place to explore these topics. I'm able to contribute a lot more. So now the Year Zero Collective online community is where I'm spending my time answering questions, debating ideas, exploring all these topics. So I hope you'll join us over there. It's called the Year Zero Collective because Year Zero is about fresh starts, reboots, new beginnings, and diving into the next stage of our life. Hope you'll join us. All the information is at yearzero.io, so check that out. And with that, let's dive in. So this is option one of the new Command Center dashboard. This one is modeled after the old one. It should look familiar, but you'll see some new additions to it. It definitely has a better aesthetic look, but beyond that, it has a lot more functionality. So let me walk through it. First of all, we still have focus and alignment, and then we have growth, home life, and business. Those are the categories we've always had. But notice everything under it is much more dynamic now. Starting with focus and alignment, we have our most important dashboards. There are three super dashboards in the whole pillars, pipelines, and vaults system. Three what you might call mega dashboards. Those are the command center itself, the alignment zone, and the action zone. Those are here. So we're in the command center. Within it, we have the action zone and the alignment zone. So those have a special home under the focus and alignment, which is the central function of the whole pillars, pipelines, and vaults system, at least the pillars and pipelines part of it. And then we highlight the knowledge vault because that is the aggregation of all of our best thinking and all the best insight we've collected and all the best wisdom across all the topics that are of interest. So these are the three power links within the system, and they're accessible right there. Under that, we've got a module here for daily tracking, weekly review, monthly review, and quarterly review. These are quick links, so I click that. It'll take me right to the daily insight section, the daily tracking section of the alignment zone. I click the weekly, it takes me right to the weekly block of the alignment zone, so I can do my weekly review. Same thing with the monthly, it takes me right to the monthly block of the alignment zone for the monthly review, and the quarterly takes me to the quarterly block of the alignment zone. So quick access to our review cycles. Now, in the last video, we talked about the expanded role of pillars. Pillars are now not only the organization and categorization of each aspect of our life, but they now function as the primary dashboard for that part of your life. So instead of just having floating loose links as we used to, it was really more of kind of a menu or a bookmark page. Now we are actually embedding the pillars and filtering them by growth and active for the growth column, filtering by home life and active for the home life column, and filtering by business and active for the business column. So these are the actual pillars listing here, which is super powerful because, as I explained in the previous video, we are now using the pillar entries in the pillars database as the dashboards for these parts of our lives. So it'll be the dashboard for health and fitness, for mental clarity, which some people might use as spirituality, for mind expansion, which some people might prefer calling learning, or family, household, whatever, business and team and client operations and content and product development. These are the dashboards for all them. They're now organized by growth, home life, and business, but they're dynamic. They're not just random hardwired links. They are the actual listings from our pillars database. And now that those are the dashboards, that makes everything more intertwined and automated. So as we update our pillars, we're automatically updating our command center. And I'll show you more about that in a little bit. Down here, we've got a quick capture spot for notes, meetings, and ideas. So this is our notes and ideas database. We've got a link here for just a quick entry. It's a big giant box. It's easy to hit on mobile, easy to hit here. All of this looks amazing on mobile. It works really well. The one thing I like to do on mobile is turn this to gallery view. So I leave it for list view on the desktop because it's a little more compact, but on mobile, by turning it to gallery view, you get a nice big box that's easier to press with your finger. Instead of a small link, the whole box is pressable on the mobile phone. But for desktop, I leave it here. And it'll remember each context separately. So if this is the way I left my desktop settings, this is the way desktop will be when I come back to it. If I have mobile on the gallery view, that will stay on the gallery view, even when I'm using this in list view. So again, more dynamic, automated. As you update the pillars, you're automatically updating the command center. As you update the command center, you're automatically updating the pillars. It's now all one and the same. Each of these is now linked to a full dashboard. So we'll link into the Mind expansion as we've seen in the previous video. We got the full dashboard here. And then we've got all the links above to any reference to this pillar across the entire system. Then down here, we've got some new structures. This is a stack of all the databases. This is every database in the entire system right here. And these are widgets. Any widgets, I have the top layer as a keyboard shortcut and the rest as embeddable widgets. So you can open and use as needed and just stack widgets down here for whatever purpose might be useful. The database stack is super valuable. This is the pillars, pipelines, and vault stack and the cycle and review stack. This all used to be over in the left navigation. I've now moved it all into this database. Now the entire system is contained within the command center. And within these, you'll see the pillars and the pillar supports, the pipelines, the core alignment pipelines, and then specialty pipelines. Core alignment pipelines are the action items or tasks, projects, goal outcomes, and value goals. Specialty pipelines are the content production in my case, which could be a specialty production board for anybody. I did a whole video on the content pipeline and explained how you could use that for any kind of regular routine special project, such as product development or inventing or writing or any kind of creation that has a frequent flow of mini projects moving through various stages of completion. Client operations are a specialty pipeline in the pipelines here. And in the cycles and reviews, we've got daily tracking, weeks, months, quarters, and then cycle review gallery, which is just a nice visual view of all these, and accomplishments and disappointments, which are part of the cycle support. Within the weekly reviews, we're capturing our accomplishments and disappointments. And then within the months and quarters, we're reviewing trends within our accomplishments and disappointments. But all of these are stacked here, easy to find, quick to find. These are the actual original sources of each of these databases. This is the entire database structure of the entire pillars, pipelines, and vault system embedded in the dashboard right here. These are the original databases, not linked databases. You'll see in the vaults, we've got a lot of them. We've got the knowledge vault, we've got the global vault, and then the specialty vaults again. The global vaults are the primary ones, the knowledge vault, which is the king of all of our vaults, the notes and ideas, media vault, tool skills services vault. There's a separate video on each of these if any of these are new to you. And then we've got specialty vaults like training and course vault, standard operating procedures vault, quote vault, team member vault, whatever you need. Build this out as you wish, but you embed them here, and this is the source of accessing all your vaults. And then cycle and reviews. So this is super compact, but incredibly dense with capability and power. Now I've tagged a little index here to show the core system databases versus the insight databases. You'll remember in our alignment zone, we've got the insight section up here. The insight section includes our cycle reviews. So we're using similar tagging. The big red dot indicates cycle reviews. These are cycle reviews here. This is the key. These are the cycle reviews here. An open circle is a core system database. So that's our pillars, our pipelines, and our vaults. So this is one implementation of the new version 2 dashboard, but this isn't actually the one that I'm using. There's another alternative that I'm using. This one, you can see the evolution from the previous one, so I wanted to show you this first. But the one I'm using in an alternate option that's employing the exact same concepts and principles, this is the alternate version. And I like this one a little bit better personally, because it's more compact. I find it's a little bit easier to get to the various aspects, but it's a bigger departure from the previous one, so I wanted to show you the other option as well. They have the same functionality, but the big difference is this one has the pillars linked in one embedded presentation, still organized by growth, business, and home life. So it's the same grouping and categorization, it's just in one list, which uses less real estate and gives us a more compact presentation. The benefit of that is that I can move the database stack up here. And that's helpful because I'm frequently opening these, especially the vaults, to get to the vaults, and having them higher means when I open them, I don't have to scroll down as far. When it's down here and you open the vaults, you always have to scroll down to get to them. In this new version, I open them here and they're pretty much available to me in one view. and these are more compact. The section over here is exactly the same. I've added, in addition to the notes and ideas, quick add. I've added an action items quick add. You could easily add this to the other one. In fact, I intend to do that. And then I've also added this one toggle down here so I could just get a quick view of my today action items list. Obviously, this is laid out much more elaborately in the action zone, but if I happen to be on the Command Center dashboard, I can just hit that toggle and just check where I am going through the day in my prioritization for today. It's the exact same list as in my action zone, just more concise with a list view. So it's an easy, quick reference. Both this today toggle and this action item toggle could easily be added in here if you wanted to. Maybe stick it over here. But this gives us the same format we've traditionally had with all the new functionality. And this gives us a little bit more innovative layout, more compact, I think a little more functional because of the positioning of the toggles higher, so a little bit easier access. So this is the one that I'm using day to day, but I wanted to present both because they're both super functional and both an enhancement over what we've seen previously. So I hope this is helpful. One thing you'll see in my dashboards that's different from pretty much everybody else's dashboards out there is that I try to keep all of the power and the most important parts above the fold, which means above the scrolling line. And in this case, for the Command Center, both of these, all of it is kept above the scrolling line. None of these giant endless dashboards that just go on and on and on. You just have to scroll, or click a link, jump down there, and you don't know where your positioning is. It's all here, all the capability, and this is a powerful, dense dashboard. This has incredible capability, and it's all in the most efficient use of real estate above the scrolling line. So I just think that makes this the ultimate Command Center dashboard, and this is what I'm working with and wanted to share it with you so that you guys now see how to adapt your systems to incorporate these new ideas. And then finally, there's one new tweak. Since we're laying out the dashboard presentation by embedding the pillar database, we can now jump into the pillar listings, and we have this additional active setting. We have active CC and active no CC. CC means Command Center. So you can have active and visible in the Command Center, or active but not visible in the Command Center. So right here we have health and fitness. That's active CC. Let's say we change it to no CC. Now we go back to the Command Center and health and fitness is gone. So this is filtered by active CC. It's removing the non-actives because even though it's the dashboard to everything happening within that pillar in your life, some of them you just don't go into that often, and you may not want to have as much clutter on your Command Center. So the ability to streamline just the dashboards in the pillars database that are most important to you is something we've now built into the system with the filter and this active CC or no CC toggle option. And there you have it. Those are the two new variations of the version 2 Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults dashboard. Hope you find them interesting. I'm super excited about them. I think they're way more capable, faster to use, have a lot more power, much more automation, because again, as we update the Pillars system, as we update our vaults, as we update anything within the system, it's automatically reflected in these new Command Center dashboards. And we have the ability to extremely quickly add new notes and ideas and tasks. And both of these work brilliantly on the mobile phone. A lot of dashboards are designed to really only work on the desktop. These dashboards work extremely well because of their compact nature, easy to hit, easy to scroll through, very concisely laid out, so it works great on mobile as well as desktop. Next up, we're going to do a more concise overview of the entire Pillar, Pipelines, and Vault system, kind of wrapping all these concepts together. And then we're going to dive into some more specialty areas within the system that we haven't had a chance to touch on yet, things like mindset and journaling and lots of other specialty areas. If this is of interest, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get updates on future videos, leave thoughts or questions below, or join us in my new online community for a broader conversation. That's available at yearzero.io. And hit like if you found this video valuable. I also write a newsletter called Mind and Machine on increasing human capability. I give away several of my best Notion templates to anyone who subscribes to the newsletter. You can, of course, unsubscribe at any time, but I hope you'll give it a chance. I work super hard to pack it with a lot of valuable insight. The newsletter link is also below in the show notes. Thanks for watching. Lots more to come.